Hey guys, your boy Carpers, and welcome back to my Liverpool whole FIFA 16 career mode, where last time I left off in my stream of a couple of days ago. Of course, I ended hit the stream by winning the Capital One Cup. In this episode, I have games against Crystal Palace, but first I'm playing Chelsea. Yes. This is very ironic because this will be going up the same day that Liverpool beat Chelsea 3-1. And yeah! And people are going to say, oh, Chelsea are shit this season. You shouldn't be happy about beating Chelsea. Actually, yeah. They're still the Premier League champions until it's officially won by City or Arsenal, whoever is going to win it this season. And until then, being the Premier League champion still means a hell of a lot. But speaking of beating Chelsea, I need to beat Chelsea because this is the reverse fixture of the fixture that happened today. In the fixture that happened today, in the game, I drew 0-0. The only time I've dropped points this season. As you see, I can't even play the man who scored Liverpool's first and second goals in today's match. There is no Coutinho. He is just too tired. If I played him, I'd have to take him off as a substitution. Same with Origi. Correa is coming in and instead. I was even a bit iffy on whether Sturridge was fit enough. He should have enough of Coutinho and Origi are on the bench, so if I need him, I will bring him on. But hopefully Firmino, in what is probably his first start, and Correa can provide what I need. It was around about the Correa match, the corresponding opposite match, is when I first dropped Correa for his poor performances. So maybe he can convince me to put him back into the starting lineup. But he will have to do a lot to get back into this starting lineup, especially with Origi being the second top goal scorer. There's a bit of an unfair advantage. It's a bit of a chance to increase that particular lead. It doesn't extend if the goal is scored by Mr. Gareth Bale, whose form has picked up. I don't know how, but this fucker, he heard me. He heard me. He heard me complain about him. And in this stream yesterday, he was fantastic. And he's opened the scoring in here against Chelsea. He, of course, former Spurs player. Not a big admirer of Chelsea. Yeah, I can't imagine. Then again, they did sign and former Arsenal player, Cesc Fabregas, so that's like, you know. I'm not even gonna get into all that crazy transfer shit. But it took 4 minutes to do what I couldn't do in 90 at Stamford Bridge. And the irony of that is, Chelsea scored in the 4th minute in the real life game. Came through Ramirez. I better not get sloppy and let them and back into it, because Chelsea, I don't know what the problem is at Chelsea in real life, but wow, they need some serious fucking help. Jose Mourinho is he must, his job must be hanging on by a thread. And I think what make another shot. And there's the shot, so oh, it's way, way over the bar. In real life. It is unbelievable. Chelsea are getting really bad. And it's, I don't understand, you know. A lot of people say the team are underperforming, and that's true, they are. The Chelsea players are underperforming. They're not as good as they were last season when they were winning in games practically for fun. They had 4 defeats in all of the last campaign, and they have 9 so far this campaign. It's just not good enough. It's just not good enough for the reigning Premier League champions. It is absolutely crazy. And I know this statement that I'm about to say is going to sound crazy, but watching Chelsea today, and you know, I know yes, they did go ahead. But no, listen. If you watched that game like I did, you saw it. You saw it. If Chelsea continue playing as bad as they did today, if Chelsea cannot fix whatever problems is going on, they have problems, and whatever it is if they do not fix it, they could end up trying to be being in the relegation battle. Yeah. They could possibly be in that bottom 3 scrap at the end of the season. And before anyone says, before anyone comments, you know, like, oh, that I'm wrong or I'm imagining it, Chelsea are that bad. I mean, Chelsea are playing bad. And you know, a lot of people. Well, don't. No one knows why. No one can understand why. Yes, John Terry and Ivanovic are a year older. But you can't blame it all on the fact that 2 of your defenders are a year older. Just because they're a year older doesn't make up for losing 9 games on the trot. Why is Hazard not performing? And like he's. I mean, last. Yeah, he was given the award basically saying he was the best player in the Premier League. And Hazard is one of the best players in the league. A lot of people don't give him as much credit as he deserves. But yes, he is one of the best players in the league. Anyone will tell you that. Hazard would be on any team in the Premier League. Absolutely any team. I don't care which team it is. He would be on that team 100%. There is no team in the Premier League that would say, nah, I'm not going to play him. You know, it's getting to the point where you're like, why are Chelsea this bad? Maybe Mourinho has done something that pissed the players off, and they're like, you know what, sod this. This guy is an absolute prick. And, well, yes, Mourinho is a prick. Everyone knows he's a complete narcissistic prick. Everyone knows Mourinho, whose only true love in life is winning and himself. Those are the only 2 things he cares about, is himself and winning. When he's not winning, he's a sour puss, and he can't admit it when he was outplayed. Did anyone else see the interview he gave to BT Sport after the game, directly after the game? He said nothing. He said he could say nothing. I'm like, Are you fucking for real? Give us our props, you absolute tosser. I mean, when Liverpool are bad, I will admit they were bad. But Mourinho, he cannot do that. He cannot admit when the team is playing bad. He cannot say it because he would be criticizing himself, and Mourinho hates to be criticized. If there's anything Mourinho hates more than losing, and it's being criticized for losing. He is treating this his job like it's all, like he's supposed to be he unbeatable.
Well, it's a goal worth replaying over and over again, isn't it?
He thinks he should be unbeatable, and if you looked at the team last season, you'd say Chelsea deserve a champions. Yeah, they poor in the last couple of games, but overall, they deserve to be champions. This season, Chelsea wouldn't even have to win the Community Shield, which they didn't. And let alone the Premier League. Chelsea look a shell of the four themselves. Us Liverpool fans, we criticised Brendan Rodgers for turning a team that finished second and challenged for the league title, or almost won the fucking thing, should have won the fucking thing, into a team that finished seventh. And Rodgers quite rightly lost his job. To me, the exact same thing is happening at Chelsea. The only difference is Chelsea did win the league, but now they're having a aftermath season syndrome. And that pretty much this is the third Rodgers season. This Rodgers had a good season. He sure won the league. He didn't win the league. Okay. One remembers, you know, the Steven Gerrard slip at Chelsea, and then the a lazy performance against Crystal Palace that led to Liverpool not winning the title. Liverpool sure won the title, and any he neutral fan will tell you that. I've heard Arsenal fans like EMGH say it. I've heard Newcastle fans like the True Geordie say it. And I've heard West Ham fan and Spencer Owen say it. Those are three neutrals. And Arsenal, who fans most years at the start of the season, their only hope is that they might challenge. This season is probably going to be their best season. If City mess up once, it could be Arsenal's to win. Now, Olivier Giroud may have gotten injured. I was watching just before I started recording this, and apparently Giroud went down with a knee injury in the first half against Swansea. I don't know if he's played on, but Arsenal cannot afford to lose Giroud, because Welbeck is already injured, Walcott just recently got injured, and Oxlade-Chamberlain is injured. They're going to end up having only Sanchez, and Sanchez will be forced to play as striker. And I mean, Sanchez is good, you know. He's performed at striker before. And, you know, he'll probably do a very decent job for Arsenal there. He'll probably get a lot more goals. Also, you know, he's not gotten a lot of goals since he came to Arsenal. He gets them every so often. And he probably gets more assists than he would goals. Because he's a winger, wingers normally do get more assists than goals. But they chip in every now and again, and Sanchez is very good at that. And Arsenal fans, they know he's very good at that. That's one of the reasons they were so happy when Wenger signed him. And they were, and they're very happy that he's such a good player. And overall, it was clear from the moment he came into Arsenal, well, he was going to be a very good player for them. Arsenal have a very good team. But if you could pair Arsenal's team with Chelsea, who has the better players? And I don't care if you're the most diehard Arsenal fans, realistically, Chelsea have a way better players. They're just not performing. Why are they not performing? I don't know. Mourinho does not know. Ooh. The owner does not know. The board does not know. No one at Chelsea, no one who supports Chelsea knows. They see the players are underperforming and they just are like, what's going on? You know, where's the team we were watching last season? Bring that team back. This shamble mess isn't the team we've come to support. And that's what Chelsea fans are thinking. I know a lot of Chelsea fans who are always saying that Chelsea need something new. Now that today, it was very evident that the fans were very clearly behind Jose Mourinho, and that's fine. You know, having a bit of faith in the manager is very good. You know, not every team has that belief in the manager. Take my team Liverpool for instance, and we knew we could not keep Brendan Rodgers, and try and perform like the big team in that we want to be. We want to be back among the top teams. We're not considered one of the top teams anymore. Well, because, you know, people say, our Liverpool don't finish in the top four. Yeah, we admit we don't finish in the top four. We're not deluded. We don't pretend we're in there. Yeah. We can't pretend we're playing Champions League football when we're playing the Europa League. We can't. Brendan Rodgers goes into the Europa League, and he goes into the Champions League. What did he do? He performed terrible in there, and he signed no one that would go. You know, the players he signed would have signed for us if we didn't get top four. But no other team in the top four were looking at any of those players that we signed in that particular season, especially the likes of Mario Balotelli. Mario Balotelli was thrown away by City because they knew, they were like, why do we need this guy who's just going to cause us problems and stuff when we have the likes of Aguero? And the fact that City could buy any backup striker they want. If they wanted it on the 1st of January, if they want to buy a backup striker to Aguero, which they probably will do because I think this injury to Aguero, even though City are still winning, it is affecting them. And they are thinking maybe we should look at perhaps a backup striker option. C won't care because the financial fair play rule that the FA brought in, it's more like guidelines because, well, Chelsea can just buy whoever the fuck they want, spend as much as they fucking like, and no one gives a shit. And somehow FIFA is the only a football organization being looked into for perhaps corruption. It is quite unusual. Oh, I mean, if I was Liverpool manager and I'd gotten, if I had the season, if I was Brendan Rodgers after that second season, I'd be like, right, should have won the league there. Should have won the league there. I'm going to go out and get champ players who are, and we're going to be in the Champions League. We need to strengthen this team so we can compete with the likes of Real Madrid, Barcelona, not beat them because, I mean, I don't think we could have signed any players that would have helped us beat them, but, I mean, it didn't help that he had to replace Suarez, but that can't be blamed. He can't put the blame all on the fact that he lost Suarez. It's just because you lost Suarez, but we were in the Champions League. He signed a world-class striker to replace him. World-class strikers are attracted to Champions League football. We had that, and you got Mario Balotelli. And that's why Brendan Rodgers got the sack. Jose Mourinho had a similar Now, he didn't have a big exit from the team. No one significant. In fact, no one at all, really. The only player who left Chelsea in the summer was Cech. He went to Arsenal. And they signed Begovic. And even I was like, Begovic, that's not bad. I mean, Begovic always does well for Stoke. He knows the league. I mean, he's going to have no problems if he's called upon to do the to be in goal for Chelsea every now and again. Granted, Chelsea obviously didn't expect him to check Courtois to get injured and be out for as long as he is. But they can't blame him on that either. They cannot blame. You know, it's a stroke of bad luck, and it's just, it's hard to watch. Chelsea, he, like I said, didn't have the huge exit that Liverpool did, but they did the same thing as Liverpool. They, well, not 100% the same thing. Liverpool brought in players who were not good enough. And did not improve the team. In fact, the players weakened the team. And that is why Rodgers has such a bad follow-up season. And that is why he is no longer the manager now. It's a real tussle between the two of them. But Brendan Rodgers got through that terrible follow-up season to the second place finish. And I could see Mourinho being given the whole of this season, and if it doesn't work, he might be fired at the end of the season. I don't think he'll be fired during the season. Because, you know, obviously, the Chelsea owner, he seems to trust Mourinho. He trusts Mourinho. Because most teams, if they fire a manager, won't bring that manager back. But that's exactly what Chelsea have done. And Mourinho came back after a spell. Those are teams. Very successful spells at our teams. And Chelsea were like, right, we need manager. We know this guy's good. We can get him. And he'll come to us and he'll do a job. Mourinho's first. And he very cleverly, he for some reason did not think Chelsea could win the league. And he very cleverly, He stopped everyone from thinking, oh, Chelsea are going to win the league. He will obviously win them the league. by calling Chelsea a small horse. Anyone remember that? I'm sure you all remember that. And he called them a small horse every single week. He called them a small horse, the small horse. I was like, why is he calling them the small horse? It was only later in the season. I was like, that cheeky fucker. He knew, for some reason, somehow he knew Chelsea weren't going to win in the league. That particular season. And he was like, there's a small horse. And so everyone would be like, okay, fair enough. Then it's between City and Liverpool. Ricardo Rodriguez. And Mourinho could not do that again. He cannot use that line again because people will be saying, hang on a second, how are you a small horse? You won the league last season and with the exact same players. So he can't use that same small horse analogy again because no one's going to buy it. So Jose Mourinho, long story short, he will get the time to try and fix it, and if he can't fix it by the end of the season or at some point during next season, he'll end up like Brendan Rodgers and Chelsea will be looking for another new manager. And Jose Mourinho will be sacked again by Chelsea. And people saying, would he come back again? Absolutely fucking not. Mourinho will probably go to somewhere like France or maybe back to Spain. You know, if Real Madrid, if things don't work out with Rafa Benitez at Real Madrid, I'm sure Real Madrid wouldn't blink at having him back. I'm sure he'd love to be back at Real Madrid. It's where he wouldn't have the any sort of hassle. Again, as depending on whether on what happens with Rafa Benitez with Real Madrid this season. We'll see what happens. And so, but that is those are my thoughts on Jose Mourinho and all the problems that are going on at Chelsea. Reminds me of what happened with Liverpool. You know what? I mean, Chelsea can only... You know what? I'm not going to talk about it anymore. I've talked about the problems at Chelsea too much. I might go into it more. If I do a Premier review, for some reason I forgot to do it earlier in the week. If I remember, I will do it on Monday. But yeah, sorry about that. Sorry I didn't get a Premier review out of last week's results. Yeah. I have a schedule I like to keep, and yeah, sometimes I fall behind on that schedule. So yeah. That's everything done. I've completed the two games, a 3-0 win against Chelsea and a 2-0 win against Crystal Palace, sorry. Mine went blank there for a second. What their name was. I don't know why I mentioned them on a few occasions. Actually, mentioned him, I think, once. Oh, yeah, in the video, and I was like, oh, well. But, yeah, good wins over tough teams. Obviously, Chelsea, not in the same crisis as they are in real life. And I've talked about that enough. I think you all will quite rightly sick of hearing me talk about which Chelsea. He bottom line is Liverpool beat them 3-1. This will hopefully give us the confidence to beat Rubin Kazan on Thursday and push on to get more points in the league. And push on to maybe challenge for that fourth place spot. So, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoy.